This episode of SciShow is made in partnership with our friends at What's What, a show about electricity. You can head to their channel and learn more about this important yet invisible topic by clicking the link in the description down below. In 2021, the Parker Solar Probe fulfilled its mission to touch the sun. Okay, technically it dove into the corona, which is the sun's upper atmosphere. But touching the sun is how NASA described the accomplishment. And what an accomplishment it was. Temperatures in the corona are over 1,000,000 degrees Celsius, hundreds of times hotter than the highest melting point of any metal. So, why the heck didn't it melt? Part of the answer is technology. Parker's got a high-tech protective shield made of a super light carbon foam that's really good at staying cool. But even this shield couldn't survive anything close to 1,000,000 degrees. And luckily, it didn't have to, because physics saves the day another way. Thanks to physics, it's possible to have hot without heat. In everyday life, we tend to mix up the two. When temperatures shoot up, we complain about the heat. But when it comes to physics, temperature and heat are two very different things. When something is hot, like a driveway or the air, that means its particles have a lot of kinetic energy. Basically, they're zipping around really fast. So temperature is a property of a substance. But heat is something else. It's a process of transferring energy between two things with different temperatures. Like, if you run barefoot down a scorching driveway to pick up your mail, the particles from the concrete will bump against your skin, transfer some of their energy, and make your skin heat up. Heating can happen a few different ways, but how much heating depends on both the heat source and the thing being heated. Two substances with the same temperature won't necessarily cause the same amount of heating. Like, you can stick your hand in a hot oven, and the air won't burn you, but the hot pan sure will. That's because air is way less dense than solid metal, so it has way fewer particles bumping into your skin at any given moment. Compared to the pan, it would take way longer for the air to transfer enough energy to your skin to burn it. This is the main reason why the Parker Solar Probe can survive six-figure temperatures. The particles in the sun's corona are incredibly few and far between. The density over there is like 10 trillion times less than Earth's atmosphere. So even though each individual particle will pack a punch whenever Parker does collide with one, collectively, there aren't enough collisions to heat the spacecraft up to metal melting temperatures, at least not during a relatively short plunge. During its first visit, Parker dipped into the corona for a few hours, but its heat shield never got hotter than about 1,400 degrees Celsius. And thanks to that shield, the inside of the craft chilled at a mere 30 degrees Celsius. In other words, this probe stayed around the temperature of an average summer day while it blazed through the atmosphere of the sun. Maybe one day engineers will design a much more complicated craft that lets a bunch of squishy humans visit the sun without melting too. Thanks to What's What for supporting this SciShow video. What's What is a YouTube channel powered by Nexans, a leading cable company committed to promoting sustainable energy. It's hosted by Frederick Lesser, one of their top engineers and science communicators, and also features some science YouTubers you might already know. It's the perfect intersection of YouTube nuts and science fans like what you find on this channel that you already watch. If you don't have time for the comprehensive, in-depth science of electricity, you can check out their Ask Me What series, where they find answers to your electricity questions and introduce you to fun facts about electricity. If you're still tucked into spooky season, you can watch their Ask Me What episode about electricity fears. You can find that video and more in the link in the description below. And thanks for watching.